Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end. Also, if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today a different topic that we are going to pick up, that is the accounting cycle. Accounting cycle, I mean, that flows in around every company now. What exactly is the accounting cycle? That's what we need to understand. See, accounting cycle is like a traditional concept. But if you understand the accounting cycle completely, you'll be able to make some prudent decisions. As you can see in the picture, you know, he has all the things which are surrounded by the business things, you know. But what exactly is the accounting cycle? Okay, no issues. We need to understand that. The accounting cycle is basically a combination of collecting the data. It is the combination of collecting the data and for basically creating post-closing trial balance. So that's why you collect the data. And accounting cycle starts with, like, you know, a transaction, and it ends with the books of accounts, which the books of accounts gets closed, right? So there are 9 steps of accounting standards. We'll be discussing each one of them, a step-by-step process. Now, this is the diagram for the accounting cycle, which the step-by-step process. You'll first collect the data, then you will do a journal entries. You'll be writing journal entries. From those journal entries, the ledger accounts will be prepared. And once you have all the ledgers, you'll pick up the ledger and its balance and form an unadjusted trial balance. You'll do some adjusting entries to tally your trial balance if there is any problems there. Then you'll prepare adjusted trial balance. From that trial balance, you will be posting the every single line item to various parts, like the profit and loss account, to the balance sheet, or trading accounts. And once you're prepared, like with the financial statements, that is a CFS, that it includes the cash flow statements, balance sheets, P&L notes. Once you're prepared that, you'll be closing your books of accounts, and then you'll be preparing a post-closing trial balance. So let's understand this every single part of this step in a much detailed form. The first is the collection of data and analysis of transaction, right? So at this juncture, you know, the accounting cycle begins. It has just started, and in the first step of the accounting cycle, the accountants of the company, they basically collect the data and analyze the transaction. Now, for smooth running business, you can say that there would be many transactions. So the accountant needs to look at each transactions and find out why they have actually occurred and put it under the right accounts and basically analyze the same. So the step is the most critical of all, because this is, like, you know, a kickstart process for the accounting. The next portion in this, the next step, is the journalizing, or you can say journal entry, basically. It's a journalizing. After collecting and analyzing the transaction, it's time to record the entries into the first books of accounts. So in this step of accounting cycle, each transaction, okay, it is compared to the general, you can say, journal entries. And under each entry, a narration is written to mention the reason behind debiting or creating the item. Now, recording the entries in the journal is important, since there is an error that is at this stage of recording, and it will linger on the next books of accounts as well, so needs to be taken care of. The third portion in this is the recording of the journal entries into the ledger accounts, right? So in this portion, accounting is basically a series of steps that are taken one by one. So after journalizing all the transaction, it's time for the accountant to record the entries into the secondary books of accounts. So that means if there are cash and capital, if there are basically cash and capital, there will be like 2 tables in the general ledger, and the balance of the respective accounts will be transferred. So the general ledgers, basically, they allow the accountants to get a closing balance for preparing the trial balance. And in the next step of the accounting cycle, it's creating the unadjusted trial balance, right? Now, as you know, the trial balance is the source of all the financial statements, and that's why special attention should be given to the trial balance. Now, from the closing balance of the general ledger account, an unadjusted trial balance is prepared. Now, in this trial balance, the debit balance will be recorded on the debit side, and then the credit balance will be recorded on the credit side. So then the debit side is total and the credit side is basically total. And then the accountants will see whether both of the side have the similar balance or not, which is called as tallying the balance sheet. Right. The fifth step in our accounting process is performing adjusting entries. Now, at this juncture, the unadjusted trial balance is already prepared. So in this step of accounting cycle, the adjusting entries are been recorded. So the adjusting entries are typically related to, you know, any accrual adjustments or periodical depreciation adjustments or amortization adjustments and so on and so forth. So without performing this adjustment entries, no adjusted trial balance would be prepared. The sixth step is creating the adjusted. The sixth step is basically creating the adjusted trial balance. Right. So after passing the adjusting entries, it's time to create the fresh trial balance. And the trial balance is called the adjusted trial balance since it is prepared after the adjustments that has been done. After the adjustment entries has been passed as a result. So the trial balance can be used to prepare the most important for the financial statement. Now, the seventh step is basically creating the financial statement from the trial balance. So this step of accounting cycle is the most critical part of the accounting cycle. See, as an investor, you must know how all the financial statements are coming from. So from the adjusted trial balance, all the financial statements are born. So there are four most important financial statements that are prepared using the adjusted trial balance. The first financial statement that every investor should look into the income statement. So in the income statement, the first item is sales, cost of sales, and other operating expenses that are deducted from the sales. The next is the balance sheet. And that includes all the data on the list of the balance sheet, like the balance sheet we record, the assets and the liabilities. Then you have the shareholders' equity. This is the next financial item that would be prepared here along with the share capital, that retained earnings would be taken into account. Retained earnings are like the percentage of the profit that has been reinvested in the company. Then you have the cash flow statement, that is a CFS. Finally, the CFS would be prepared in cash flow. You know, accountant needs to find the cash flow from the kind of various activities like operating, financial, investment. It can be prepared with two things, like, you know, two ways, indirect and direct method. And the eighth step is basically closing the books. Now it's time to close the books. The step is the last step. I mean, this the third last step in the accounting cycle. Closing the books basically means that all the financial statements are prepared and are recorded. After closing the books, a new accounting period would start and would need to start repeating the above steps of the accounting cycle once again. The step nine that will go is finally creating the post-closing trial balance. So the post-closing trial balance is, you know, to ensure that the accounting transactions are properly recorded, analyzed, and summarized. So a post-trial balance is prepared, and here all the accounts are taken into account, and then the closing balance is where are recorded as for the respective positions. So then the credit side of the and the debit side are being matched to see whether everything is right or not. So conclusion out of all the steps, if an investor can understand the nine steps of the accounting cycle, it would be clear that how he or she should approach the company and progress or decline. So the knowledge of the accounting cycle will help you to decide whether he or she should invest in a company or not. And at the same time, he will get a concrete idea about the financial accounting of the company.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.